podcast. Brian here, Stogie Review, Ipcpr 2018. I'm here with my man, Rick Rodriguez. We're going to talk about CAO. What's happened with CAO,
We have a new cigar from Nicaragua. So we wanted to stand in line for the world blends. So, of course, we had the Brasilia, the Colombia, the Italian, the U.S. But why not our home base, Nicaragua?
Why not?
And so we did Nicaragua. And so what's different about Nicaragua, when you think of Nicaragua, automatically assume it's going to be bold, spicy, full body. We want to show you every coin has two sides, and we want to show you the side of the coin that we can produce a Nicaraguan cigar, more mellow, more complex in flavor, offer you some spicy joy for these cigars, but a cigar that everybody can enjoy for Nicaragua.
Sure.
So not only the market of the full body cigars, guys, because typically, if you're a mild to medium body cigar guy, you hear Nicaragua, I did it once, never again. It's too bold, too much for me. This cigar is going to allow you to receive that flavor of the unique tobacco for the blend and enjoy Nicaragua, our home base.
Very cool. So what are we looking at in terms of price points?
So we had three sizes, and the size is going to range from $5.99 to $7, so great price point.
Good price.
My fans are hard-working people. They spend money in cigars, but they're not foolish. And so we try to keep our cigars in the market of that $5 to $10 range, and this just fit well within lines.
So how soon can we look forward to buying these?
I think we're going to launch it in the first or second week of August. And it's going to be, and I'll start my events in the second week of August. So I'm out and running, starting this cigar.
On the road.
Love it.
Yeah. How long are you going to be on the road for?
I'll be starting my events in August into the third week of December.
So pretty much the rest of the year.
Yeah, so lock and load it. It's going to be fun for us to share this cigar, to share Nicaragua, to show you a different side of Nicaragua. I think you guys are going to enjoy this cigar.
So is the situation in Nicaragua, speaking of Nicaragua, the current situation, has that had any kind of an impact on production of this? Or you already had the tobacco already and you're ready to go?
That's a great question. Fortunately for us, we have a sister company in Honduras. So right now our factory is running, but we have to. We always can move they're making that cigars from Nicaragua to our Honduras. Right now we have no plans to do that, but we have the ability to do that in the future if we have to. But hopefully for us, Nicaragua is going to go back to being a beautiful country, the beautiful people, very soon. So hopefully.
Very cool.
So right now we have no problems.
Good. That's glad to hear that. And one other thing, and it's not really related to this, but I saw this on the table over here. I just had to ask about that. Look at this ashtray.
That is something near and dear to me. That's flathead. And so that is looked like in the engine block, but that's going to be, and I'm going to do another version of the red, a block, and a orange one to represent the 54 green gauge, the 60, and the 70 green gauge.
That's very cool.
Coming out, I think, in the spring time of next year.
And don't worry about the ash. I made him empty it so I can show it off.
We've been using it.
He wasn't planning on that. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank
really
you so
appreciate
much
it.
For your time, and I look forward to sharing that cigar with you guys.